What's up, guys? We are back at it again with another pumpkin recipe. But before we start, make sure to hit that like button if you're watching this video, subscribe to join the fam, and hit that notification bell to be notified whenever there's a new video. So let's get started. Start with a small pot on medium heat and use 1 cup of half and half. Then add 1/2 cup of sugar or less, depending on how sweet you want it. And then add 1 heaping tablespoon of pumpkin puree. Don't waste any pumpkin. Yeah. Make sure to not boil this. Just mix it enough so that sugar dissolves. Add 1 teaspoon of pumpkin pie spice. And my camera kind of ran out of battery while I was filming, but just add 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Then whisk it away. Leave down in the comments if you're already tired of pumpkin. Usually at the end of October, I'll be done with anything pumpkin until next year. Now, pour the mix slowly into a jar using a strainer. You'll need to do this in sections since the pumpkin is a bit thick and will stop straining. But to clean the strainer, just rinse it with water. Easy as that. Let it cool in the fridge for about 15 to 20 minutes. I know you kind of just want to drink the drink already, but trust me, it's worth the wait. To make it frothy, I'm using this froth mixer that I bought on Amazon. I'll leave it in the description box down below. It's really inexpensive, and I like this one just because it has a stand for it. Tilt the froth mixer at an angle and move it up and down. Depending on how frothy you want your pumpkin cold foam to be, just use the froth mixer longer. If you don't want it that foamy, then just don't use it that long. Grab your coffee grounds, or if you're a little bit lazy, you can just buy one of those ready-made cold brews. My roommate bought this coffee grounds on Amazon, as well as the cold brew mason jar. The mason jar actually makes the cold brew effortlessly. Just add the coffee grounds into the strainer, then you just pour the cold water and just let it sit for a while, or overnight like we usually do. Fill up your glass with ice. I'm using 4 ice cubes, then pour your cold brew and add your foam on top. And depending on how sweet you want your drink to be, you can add more of the liquid part of the cold foam into your drink. And you're done. Isn't that so easy? It was super easy, so quick, and I think I actually like it better than Starbucks, since Starbucks can be overwhelmingly sweet. But definitely give this a try, and again, if you do make this drink, give it a thumbs up and let me know down in the comments below. Bye!